everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Turnovers will be a focus in today's game. The Titans are top 10 in turnover differential, and they'll be up against a Packers team that wants to be careful not to play into that strength. With that, let's get up to Nissan Stadium in Nashville. With the call, Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
All right, thank you, Larry. We are across the Cumberland River from downtown Nashville at Nissan Stadium in Tennessee. Today we hit week 10, and we've got a good one in store between the Green Bay Packers and the Tennessee Titans. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, we take a look at this Titan ball club entering play. They come in playing pretty good football, winners of four of their last six games. Meanwhile, for the visiting Packers, we're in November now, so this is where you really need to settle in and start getting down to business.
And in baseball...
Throw it with Manning. Fuller brings it in over the middle. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second and about a yard.
When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage. And that's exactly what he got done there.
Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field.
In most pass defenses, the guy playing safety has the ability to roam free and try and go to the football. But when you're in man, you've got to cover just like a guy playing out on the...
And he's hit and taken down. Eli sacked. Chris Beck. Play action here on first down. Try to drop one in, but it's incomplete. They were looking to get it to Kelvin Benjamin there, and that'll bring up second down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Throwing again, Mariota on second and 10. And this is incomplete. He was looking for Alex Collins that time. Third down here.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
To throw Mariota. And that will be incomplete as well.
Going to four pass offense. That penalty is declined.
Too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being very precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Caught left side, Garcon. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and it'll be second down. Charles, the lowest head back. And they'll give it to him here. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. It'll be a gain of 2 on the play, but they'll remain a few inches short here with third down looming. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line.
Brandon, I'll make this one really simple. When Jamaal Charles is operating at this level, his team is awfully hard to beat.
Absolutely. All-time leading rusher for the Kansas City Chiefs and just doing his thing once again. We've seen this so many times in his career.
And there have been some big-time runners in Kansas City history. Jamaal Charles standing at the top of that heap now.
A pickup of 4 on first down. It'll be second and goal. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yeah, it's now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
A second down carry for Booker. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. And give him 2 yards officially, and now it'll be third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you...
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Corey Brown, his second touchdown on the season. Second and short. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. They'll throw again. Mariota. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
And he finds Cook. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two.
But they were in the red zone, and they needed a first down. Was it a surprise to you that they went to the tight end?
Not at all. I thought, though, the defense might put a little more pressure on him, but still able to complete it. From the 2 yard line now, it's first and goal. And he's going to get this back to the 3 yard line and no further. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
So if I'm an offensive coordinator, there's one thing that I know for sure. This is one of the top five teams in the NFL against the run. So when I look at my playlist, I'm probably thinking about throwing it.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he's maybe going to get this back to the four, but that's about all. Line of scrimmage at the four. Here's third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the...
Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. Martavis Bryant, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Titans... Now as they make their way back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he sensed being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
And probably the wise decision there. No one open. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now Manning. Going underneath for Charles. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It'll be a gain of 4. And that is going to set up a 3rd and 1.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end. But running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to get it back to a 1-score game. And Bailey able to knock it through. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. So with just under 40 seconds to go, you figure this is going to need to bounce their way if they have any shot. And the Titans are going to come up with it. And that should just about do it. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
On 2nd down, Williams. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the Packers pick it up. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line. For the Titans, Charles, 2nd most fumbles last year in the league behind Cleveland. They had 16.
And that's what happens as a young team starts to grow, you know, as they try. This challenge was initiated by the guys in New York taking a look at the play. Less than 2 minutes to go.
Yeah, I'm sure the... Now the Packers going to take another timeout. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. This one will sail out of bounds. It'll depend on the spot here. And the side judge says that went out at the 7-yard line. The Packers offense now heading back out onto the field. 1 possession game. Time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed.
And they're going to sack him again. The 5th time they've gotten him today, and this one results. results in a safety. And that 2 points you would think should end any thoughts here of a possible comeback.
Yeah, they have a long field ahead of them anyway, but now 2 scores down, you can just about chalk this one up for lost.
Can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field.
Four down.
And they will take a knee here. Charles, in this one, I think the storyline, really, the fourth quarter coming into it neck and neck, but they were able to separate, put their foot on the gas, and get the win.
And since you mentioned neck and neck, I'm going to stay with a little bit of a horse racing theme. It was that close, and then really went into the gallop and finished it strong.
One more horse racing theme.
Go.
I am glad you posted today.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. The Titans are winners here as we say so long from Nashville.